Hello, this is Dr. Carlo Oller, emergency physician and founder of edexitvideo.com. This video is about needle stick injuries. As the result of a needle stick, you may have been exposed to a blood-borne pathogen. If you're watching this, it's because you or someone you know had a possible exposure to a blood-borne pathogen. This is scary and will be for the next 6 months as the follow-up testing over this time period will be necessary. If you were diagnosed with a needle stick or significant blood-borne exposure and have any of the following symptoms, please stop the video and return to the emergency department. If you have signs of infection such as high fever or chills, if you have signs of hepatitis like yellowish skin discoloration, dark urine, or abdominal pain, if you have nausea, vomiting, any significant symptoms that were not present during your first visit, you should return. The main blood-borne pathogens we worry about are HIV, of course it causes AIDS, hepatitis B, and hepatitis C. Most kids nowadays are getting vaccinated for hepatitis B. All healthcare workers are vaccinated for hepatitis B, so it's not much of a concern, although hepatitis B can live on a dry surface up to 48 hours. Hepatitis C does not live as long on surfaces and needles that are laying around, but is very contagious. The risk of developing an infection after exposure to a blood-borne pathogen are dependent on several factors, including the route of exposure and the amount of the infectious material that could have been transmitted to you. There is a far greater risk of developing hepatitis B than there is of developing an HIV infection. The highest risk of developing HIV is from a hollow needle used in a patient with AIDS, not just HIV, but the actual infection, who has high level of the HIV virus, and the needle punctures to your skin go deeply. In this case, the risk is still low, and estimated to be about 0.3%, or 3 in 1,000. HIV-infected blood that splatters on intact skin, on injured or unbroken skin, represent almost no risk to developing an HIV infection. For example, splashing while you're cleaning a wound into your eye, even the mouth, that has a low viral load and low risk of infection. We, the physician, have special sheets and algorithms printed by the Center of Disease Control to help us determine if your exposure was significant or not significant. Your physician will determine what treatments is necessary after considering the source material, whether it was blood or bloody fluid, the exposure, whether it was a needle stick, blood splash on skin, and the volume of the fluid, was it just a small amount or a large amount, and the HIV and hepatitis status of the source if it can be tested. Washing the skin immediately and irrigating the eyes if they were exposed. Tetanus immunization and hepatitis B immunizations are necessary. Drawing blood samples to check your hepatitis and HIV status just to establish a baseline. Also, prophylactic antiviral medications, which means taking medications to hopefully prevent you from developing the disease. And antiviral medications are started, they will need to be continued for 4 weeks. Antiviral medications have been shown to decrease the risk of seroconverting. Seroconverting means turning positive to a test for viral infection when you were originally tested as negative. HIV is the only viral infection for which antiviral medications have been shown to decrease the risk of getting the disease. If you have been started on antiviral medications, you will also need to practice safe sex with the use of condoms or abstinence, so you will minimize or eliminate the risk of spreading the disease to others. Follow-up, follow-up, follow-up. Follow-up with your physician for the results of blood tests and further testing. If we did not, please make sure your tetanus shot was up to date. You have up to 3 days after the injury to get this and still be protective. For this and other videos like this, please visit edexitvideo.com. And remember, these are educational videos and should never replace the care or attention of your primary care provider.